Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Camera Tuesday, episode number 6. So today we're gonna take a look at the debate of the year, Sony versus Canon. So let's dive right into it. So main question comes to the mind is, why does this matter? One, you have to understand, every camera, especially interchangeable lens cameras, they are an ecosystem and they are a closed system. You cannot jump from one to another. So if you invested in, like, let's say a wrong ecosystem, like a Samsung interchangeable lens camera, you are stuck. So for that reason, you have to make sure you choose the right one. Second, it directly contributes to your output. Let's say you are making photos for Time magazine or Outlook or Forbes or things like that. Output matters. Your image has to match the quality that is needed for this sort of thing. And second, you have to understand, if you are a professional, you have to make sure you have as low or almost no downtime. You cannot afford downtime, especially if you are making a living out of it. So all these three things contribute to why does it matter to have a proper system. So then you also have to understand, let's say you bought the camera and all that, there is also a lot of sub ecosystem that goes into your camera, which mainly includes of battery chargers, flash, extension tubes. There are many things that you will end up buying that are specific to your camera ecosystem that cannot just go from one to another. In that scenario, you have additional investment that will become, you know, useless if you jump the system after you have invested a lot of money. So choosing things right away properly helps you save a lot of money. Like, let's say you're doing macro photography and you're like, macro lenses are way too expensive, but extension tubes are not available for Sony cameras. You're like, okay, just buy a Canon camera. So for this sort of reason, you have to make sure there's two accessories also play a very vital role. So this part is really neglected in all the debates that I'm seeing on this topic, and this plays a much crucial role than people realize, specifically in pro photography world, and that is support. Now, Sony just recently started what they're calling Sony Imaging Pro Support, and Canon also had something similar, Canon Professional Services. They had it for quite some time. They just keep renaming and rebranding it, but they had it for quite some time. So what does that mean is, think of this way. Let's say you are doing a photography event in Olympic, and you know, things are happening in the stadium, you are at the stadium and your camera broke down for some reason. Like, let's say, heck, it could be a glitch or it could something happen, and you want to go to somewhere and they are like, okay, I need this fixed. This pro services, many of them allow you to give you a loan equipment. They are like, okay, give us your equipment, we're gonna try to fix it, and this is the equipment use at the moment. So this reduces your downtime. An Olympic event is not gonna wait for you to get a camera thing sorted out. So support really matters. And you also have to understand, like, let's say it has the support, does it have the number? Like, let's say this map that I'm showing here, it's how many Sony Pro support centers are there in USA. Suffice to say, it's quite few. So it does play a role. So numbers and placement, like placement plays is much more crucially, because some companies are very prominent in some places and very lackluster in other. Like, you in Japan, you may find Sony's center quite scattered out everywhere. So, and in India, you may not find it. So placement also matters. And pro support is almost like a insurance service, which sometimes require you to pay a little bit more than your camera, and sometimes they require monthly. And they give you a sort of peace of mind, and especially in every big event, like a very big sports event, they generally set up shop right there outside the stadium just to make sure that anybody using Canon cameras or Nikon cameras, Nikon also has this, is if they have a breakdown, they can instantly get it fixed, or at least they will try to. Like, they cannot guarantee it, but they will try. So Sony just started this, and this is the reason why you don't see Panasonic, Fuji, and these sort of cameras in all the live event, so to say. Support matters is very crucial. Now, so let's come to the conclusion of this series, the reality, so to say. Every document that I'm reading online, on every video I'm seeing, is everybody is like, Canon is trying to catch up, Canon has to catch up and all that. No, Canon has worked for so many decades that they know what they are doing. And Sony is the one that is expanding into the market of photography. You have to understand, Sony makes its money from way too many consumer electronics, and they have started to spend money into interchangeable lens market. Canon also makes their money from other things. That's why they are like, you know, releasing meh camera. They're not bad camera, but they're like meh, you know, they're not like whoa grand cameras. And Sony is starting to, you know, come into the fray. That's why Sony has spent so much money to create a pro service system. That's why Sony has barely launched that service 2 years ago. Sony is catching up, not Canon. Canon has reached a point where if you see any event, like a press conference, a sporting event, most of them will have either Sony or, either Canon or Nikon. They will rarely have Sony, and Sony realizes, so they are spending a lot of money. So in all fairness, Sony is the one that is trying to catch up. Second is the lens library. This is the biggest reason why Sony is not just, you know, everywhere right now, is that their lens collection is very small, like very, very, very limitingly small. Like for average user, it doesn't matter that much. But for pro photographers, there are some pro photographers that will only do baseball. There are some photographers that will only do, you know, soccer. And they need specific lens that is targeted for that sort of sport. So basically they have a very telephoto prime lens collections. So Sony has just started to unveil their lens. So Sony has way too many lens to build and market and support than they can call they have the ecosystem for the lenses. Then you have to understand, Canon is always known in the industry as a tool. Like, you know, you pull it out, it works. Like I'm using this Canon 800D, and so far I never had an issue where, like, you know, I started it. Like, of course, if your battery is discharged, of course it's not gonna work, but near 100% of the time when you take out your Canon camera, it works. And Canon have worked very in earlier years, they have put a lot of effort, and it does show. Heck, some Canon cameras have buffers that, like, you would be surprised, they literally have no buffer. Some of the Canon Pro camera, their burst rate can be maintained until your card is full. So Canon put a lot of effort into their equipment, and nowadays everybody refers to it as a tool. Like, you know, you pull out your Canon, it works. It's not magical, it does not have, like, you know, all the bells and whistles, but it's a photographic equipment and it gets the job done. And quality control is the biggest hurdle for Sony right now. What does that mean? Sony is the only camera in the camera world that I ever come across that has heating issues. Now, it is common for video cameras, but not for compact cameras or interchangeable lens camera. So this plays a very vital role. Imagine, like, you are in outdoor environment and you are shooting a sports event. Outside temperature goes high and your camera is like, nope, I'm not gonna work. So you do understand, like, Sony really has to figure out their you know, quality control. And you might say, okay, but they have fixed it in this one, like, you know, Sony A7 Mark III series. And everybody's forgetting, like, Canon never had this issue. So you have to understand, like, if you buying an equipment, you have to make sure that the company has a good track record. And Sony is right now at a stage where every product they release make their old product looks very obsolete. So what does that mean? Think of it this way: if you had a new Canon 5D Mark IV comes into the market, you can still buy Mark III, and it won't have the latest bells and whistles, but it will still be a good camera. However, if you do that with Canon, if you did that with Sony, the current hype, the $2,000 full frame camera, and you bought the older version, you'll be like, why the heck I went from 900 shots to 200 shots? Why the heck my camera is overheating now? Like, you have to realize, like, Sony has to have a product line that entire product life inspire confidence that, like, okay, I'm gonna pull out any equipment and it's gonna work. So quality control is Sony's biggest hurdle, which I am hopeful they can fix. So this was my presentation. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, dislike, leave a comment, and subscribe, press the bell icon. I make video every day. And thanks for watching.